26. Good, state your name, who you represent. Your term is your presentation, may we press this application?
Thank you, Your Worship. Good evening, Your Worship and City Council. I'm John Klein, and here representing myself as a Regina Transit user and a driver. I'm in favor of the proposed increase to parking fines for violations outlined in the agenda. I have a question about stopping a bus stop fine. Does that include people who park in the bus-only lanes downtown on Broad and Albert Streets? I'd like to see that fine higher than $36 outlined, and I see the city actively enforcing this bylaw with tow trucks, so buses are not frequently late as they are slowed down by weaving in and out of illegally parked vehicles. As buses are given their own dedicated lanes, overall traffic average speeds increase, meaning transit users and single-occupant vehicle drivers get to where they're going faster. Parking fines or even parking meter revenue should be earmarked to be spent in the area of the city in which they're given. Pasadena is a city that's done this with their meter revenue, and were able to revitalize their downtown business district using this technique. I'm also eagerly awaiting the results of the long-ago-ordered parking study, as it will help highlight the need for more money in the upcoming budget to go to Regina Transit for more buses. And I'm waiting for the implementation of the mayor's proposed snow routes, which would also improve traffic flow and driving comfort during winter. Thank you for your attention, and I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you, Mr. Klein. Any questions or delegation? Council President.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thanks for your presentation. You ride the bus?
Yes, I do.
And this is a very common issue you come across?
Pretty much every time driving or taking the bus from the university to downtown, you'll see cars parked in the bus-only lane during rush hour. Today was an exception. I was on Albert Street instead of taking the 3 up Broad, so maybe it's, maybe since I've last seen it happen, it's maybe gotten better, but I've never actually seen a car towed for being in a bus lane. I don't know if that means it never happens or isn't actively being enforced.
Okay, thanks.